Welcome back to HPI Guys Workshop. Now today we're going to be taking a look at a massive kit Model Rectifier Corporation sent over for a full unboxing. Hobby Boss's brand new, all new USS Missouri BB-63 in 3/50th scale. When I say 3/50th scale, it's 1/350th scale. That means 350 of these models laid end to end would be the size of the real USS Missouri. This is a historic battleship from World War II. This is where the treaty to end World War II was signed, when Japan officially surrendered on its decks. Quite iconic. It is a massive kit. 3/50th scale is a very large scale. You can get an idea of the size of these ships. A 3/50th scale aircraft carrier would be even bigger than this. This box alone is 32 inches long. It is a monstrous kit. It's got some idea of what you can expect. Now, this kit is not a beginner's kit. Do not buy, if your dad or uncle or sister or aunt is a World War II buff, you can get them this model. They will be extremely pleased. But don't get them this model and tell them they can get it done in a weekend. This is an extensive kit with hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of parts, extremely detailed, has some very fine photo etch parts we're going to look at, and will take a substantial amount of time for even a master modeler to put together. I'm going to bring some stuff out on the table. We can take a look at the cool box art here. We got some computer renderings of all the gun towers. This is what they call a multimedia kit. It's going to have plastic and metal parts in it. It is, I mean, this is one of the most complicated, substantial kits I've ever seen, and worth it, because you are going to build an absolute gorgeous model when you are all done. The box says 14 plus. I highly recommend following that. Though, if you have, you know, a younger person, always determine that yourself. If you have a younger person that's really good at building models, they have a lot of patience and they have a lot of time, they too can get this kit together. I'm going to start getting some of the plastic on the table. There's so much to go through. We're going to have to break this into multiple parts, and I will be right back. Okay, what you are looking at now are the two hull pieces for this model. And unlike a lot of models of older days, this is modern technology, so the hull can be molded in one piece. Imagine what it costs to build the injection molded molds to put this much styrene. In fact, I've recently taken up cross-country skiing, and I think I'm going to exchange my skis and just wear these. I mean, you just get two of these. You could slide through any terrain. You could have a great time. This thing is huge. It's got molded-in braces in the hull. It's got positive location marks. You see these pin marks here for all of our parts in our upper deck that will attach. It's super fine because they want to do it in scale. It's got a very fine texture to the plates on the side. See all these little dimples in there? That is for locating equipment along the side of the hull. All along, they're perfectly done in scale and just exquisitely. I mean, it's even got like the hull depth markings scribed in the front there, up and down. The bottom is smooth. Not a lot of people are going to display this anywhere but sitting perfectly flat or just barely risen above the table. A waterline diorama would be wonderful in this. It is a nice gray plastic. It is semi-flexible, so it's not going to snap on you, but it's not going to warp and fold after time. I don't think you should have to install any bracing that's not included in the kit with this. Just use a high-quality liquid glue, Revell, Plastruct bonding, all of that. We can see where the propellers will come out of their runs here. The rudders, propellers, everything on the back nicely molded and relief like the real thing. They've really gone through and taken their time to get every little side detail, every little mounting hole done, so that you're not guessing and wondering and freaking out about where you should install things. Then we've got the deck here, and the deck again. Even though in 1/350th scale, things are super small, very, very small detail. But you can see all the markings to run the anchors up and down, all the plating and whatnot for the chains. The deck is wood, and you can hear that. It is in there. It's just very, very hard to see. I will get some more closer pictures with still images in a bit here. But that deck is, again, gigantic. The entire ship is about 30.5 inches long on my table. We can see the gun turrets in the back, all the little location marks for railings and everything are all molded in there. All the locations should be easy to find. Underneath, we've got all the marks to support the deck so it doesn't sag in on itself once it's attached to the hull. We've got some reinforcing and that like that. So let's just place it on and I don't even know if, wow. Okay, I haven't built a battleship since the old like Revell Arizona kits. I was expecting to say, I really was, I was expecting to say, well, you'll have to clamp that together. Look at how that fits. Now it's up a little bit, but that once you put glue on that, that's gonna hold itself right down. So the fit and finish on this modern kit is what you would expect. Let me move it around here. When we get that hull up in there, check out the fit on that. That's super nice. Great looking. It just keys into place, fits right down in. Awesome. Around the side, see how it just drops down? You don't see that? See, we can have it up a little bit. We'll push it down, and it just goes right down in. Wonderful. Run your bead of glue in there, maybe even a thicker model glue like Revell Contacta, and that will hold that in there, and then just let it sit and it holds itself in beautifully. So no warpage, no nothing on the main hull or the deck. That's going to go together so nice, and it doesn't want to sag even in the wider gap, thinner areas. It's not sagging on me, so I wouldn't think you'd need more internal bracing than what the kit would provide. Now, I'm going to get out the smaller parts on the table, move the camera up since we got this monster 30.5-inch hull. We'll get that out of the way, and I'll come back in just a moment. First up, we'll take a look at the provided stand. They even have a nice dry dock stand included in the kit for you. Or you can use a standard ship stand. It depends on what you want to use. Or you can, you know, cut the hull and make a waterline diorama. If you build this model kit, please show me on the Facebook page. I would love to see that. I would love to check that out. But you can see the nameplate is lovely, and it's designed to work with this stand on the ship, or it's designed to work with the dry dock stand, which you can detail to your heart's content. Put some 1/350th scale figures on it and on the hull of the ship, decorate it any you want. But that's what we've got for that. And on that stand, we've got our hull right above the box here. You can see it's just going to sit nicely right on it. So you do have your choices. You kind of, we'll say it's a 2-in-1 option there. Let's start getting into the styrene trees, and there are a bazillion of them molded in this nice gray, ready to accept stuff. Check out the fine details on all these little parts. I mean, this is, it's crazy. I'm always so impressed by how small some of these manufacturers can make their parts. So we'll go through every single tree in the kit. We've got a lot of superstructure detail. I don't know all the names to all these battleships, but they are quite impressive. And I mean, look at that, that little part there. This is definitely a craftsman's kit. This is not something that you're gonna blast through. I can assemble the most complex kits in like a day, a full day of working, and this thing I guarantee would take me at least 4 or 5 days just to glue together. Look at that. I got all like that. Look at the little ladders going up the side. All molded in scale. Nothing's too large. It does have, look at the doors. I mean, that's the size. Give you a perspective. There's a door right there. A sealable armored door on the side of the ship. That's the size of the figures you could get for this, and they do make them. They're usually made out of like paper or a photo etch. Got some more railings. And look at all the little fine teeth on there. Look at, check that out. Look at the side of the structures. That is insane. Someone had to draw all that up. In the old days, they would have had to actually carve that by hand to make the molds. Nowadays, they just get to draw it up on a computer, and the computer has to do all the work. We've got numerous trees that are going to be identical because you're going to be building similar things on a ship of this size. So we've got three entire parts trees of this design that we're going to bring front and center here. These are some of our main cannon. These would be the main cannon, the three guns. Look at the... Look at that. Those look like shells, magazines. And be very careful. Use high quality cutters. I, in fact, recommend using a small photo etch razor saw to cut some of these parts off. Look at that. And you gotta do this over and over and over again. So these kits are very, very intimidating, but they are so worth it when you see them displayed. So give it a shot. The worst you can do is, if it frustrates you, put it down for a week or 2 weeks or a month and come back to it later. So we're gonna have three trees like that. I'm going to start unwrapping more trees and come back with those. The next set of parts up on the table will be a lot of parts of the superstructure molded on their own trees. This is just one large part. This thing looks like it could be its own spaceball spacecraft. But this would be part of the superstructure on the ship, where the crew would be, where the radar observation, all that kind of stuff, and some guns would be. The detail on this does not fail to disappoint anywhere. I mean, even these little stowed cranes, look at that. Molded in place with a little netting that's been stowed on the side. Exquisite, such tiny, I mean, little doors, more netting. Flawless, got the, and the panel, the wood deck isn't just straight lines. They've actually staggered them so that you can see all the individual detail on the structure like that. So when you black wash it, when you wash it through there, same with this deck here, positive mounting locations for every single part that goes on, no wondering. And then when you go to assemble the superstructure onto the hull, nothing lines up. Well, you're not going to have that problem because they've designed it to be a modern kit, which is what we expect. I mean, there should be no excuses for not making things fit perfectly on a modern kit. Got some more small hatches. More of the structure. We got these two cool trees here. Slide molding is so neat. Normally, in an old model ship kit, this would be like four pieces. It'd be the slab sides, it'd be the round, and it'd be the semi-round back, and then you have to get those all together and hope they were perfect. Now, one piece, and yet covered in detail all the way around. Molded in these cool trees like that, standing up. That's so neat. Look at that tower. It's even got the ladder on the outside. And then the door, and like some of the electrical boxes in there. That's so cool. All right, time for even more trees. We're not even close to done. All right, are you ready for even smaller detail parts on your kits? Because you're going to start to see some stuff that blows your mind. Now, one thing I want to say is the box that this comes in is not the old style single panel box. It's a corrugated box. It's very stiff. They have like three or four different cardboard stiffeners in the box. I know that's important to some of you that want to store this model as a collector's item or are worried about shipping. Unless your UPS guy folds it in half and uses it as a wheel chock, there's no way that this thing is going to get damaged. Plus, these trees are bagged and then they're wrapped in padded foam as well in the box. So everything's going to stay really nice for you. You'll notice that I don't have any broken parts, no matter how small they go. Look at the open molding on that. It's nuts. There'll be like windows for that. Even has the correct bracing on the inside of these rails. That's just silly to me. That's insane. Now this one here, we've got three parts trees that were wrapped in double bagged and foam. So we'll look at one of them out of the three. They're all identical, but this is where we get into even smaller parts on the trees. Look at these, the little guns, the little support guns, vents, outlets. Check out the rafts. That's even cooler. All the way around, look at the guns. Because obviously in 350th scale, this is a massive, massive ship. And it's nothing compared to what they drive nowadays. Here we got another part of the superstructure. Looks like the lower part here. You can see where one of the cannons will mount on the front. And then the four on the side to protect the ship. Got our portholes molded in, so like little drops of black, if there's nothing mounting there, will make those look pretty nice. Even got a little life ring. So I like showing you the minute details, all in HD for you. Then of course this has the lovely deck work too. You can see we'll get the light to hit that right. The wood planking is just looks so lovely. And all the positive mounting locations. We're going to get into some more small stuff. We got two identical trees again, double bagged, wrapped in plastic. These are more guns, more life rafts, support guns, the same as what we showed before. Two more of those. And then we've got some of the running gear here. We've got two of these trees because they need to use, you won't use every part on every single tree. They have to duplicate a lot of stuff to get you multiples. But we've got our propellers here. Two different types, as you can see. Grates, rudders, and the little lifeboat. That's just exquisite molding. And this is the last of the gray plastic trees. Check out that hull. It's even got space for a little baby propeller and the rudder and the side markings on the hull and the bracing inside. Got our anchor. Yeah. These things are so cool. So we got that tree. Now I'm going to go over to the multimedia stuff and I'll see you over there. First up is what I like to call multimedia, the paper goods that are in the box. Everybody's concerned how easy these are to assemble. Well, you can see it is a book. I mean, it's a book. Also, they will include full color mark and paint guides, Mr. Hobby, Vallejo, Model Master, Tamiya, Humbrol, all the different brands represented. And if their brand isn't represented, there are reference sheets all over the internet to find out what. We'll bring that in close. You can freeze and you can order your paints right now. You can see the beautiful color and it tells you how to paint the aircraft. Yes, there are aircraft included in this kit. We'll be looking at those in a little bit. We've got the giant instruction manual here. Gives you the full parts call out so you know what to look for in the kit. And then we start right away on the main hull with the, oh, look at that. See, you learn something every day. That was not part of the stand. The dry dock is the stand. This is more internal bracing to the hull. So there you go. That shows you exactly what they're thinking of to make sure that the hull will stay rigid for you. And then we get into more building. We get into how to do your photo etch parts, how to attach them. So how many pages? We're up to page 19, step 36. 63 steps over 35 pages, 64 steps over 36 pages. That is a lot to do. When you get to the point where you're putting those cannon on, you're going to feel so relieved to have your kit done. And it's going to be so awesome. You're going to have a wonderful, wonderful model kit. For decals, this isn't a stock car. This is a wartime model ship. So you're not going to get a lot of decals with it. You're going to get the white 63s, which are right there. You're going to get flags. You're going to make sure it's the actual proper U.S. flag before they had all 50 states. And then we'll get logos for the aircraft. So that's it for your decals. We've got a bag of chain for the anchor. We've got two clear parts trees for the aircraft. Now, why are these clear? You're wondering, why would they make that clear? It's because in this scale, it would be very difficult to do a canopy correctly. So what you do is you mask off the clear canopy, and then you can paint the whole aircraft, and then just peel that mask off at the end, and your aircraft is done. And that's why they do that. So you get two trees for your float planes, and you can mount those with your model, and that way you can have your open, and then you can scratch the wings for your marker lights and stuff. Got our little propeller, and that's how they do it in this scale for the military modelers. That's what they've decided that they like the most, and that's how they do it. I will get the metal parts out. Yes, the metal parts were not done with the multimedia. The chain wasn't the only thing. We'll take a look at those in a moment. Finally, rounding out the parts in the kit, we have optional turned aluminum barrels. And these are amazing. I mean, even the little ones, I left them in the bag because they're so small. Even the little barrels on the smaller cannon, the smaller guns are there. They are turned a little open at the ends too. The main guns you can see are hollowed out on the ends. You just put a little black paint in there and you're all set to go. So you get a full set. You don't have, we saw them in plastic, but they are provided in aluminum and they look a lot better. And then photo etch parts. This isn't it, okay? There are over 400 photo etch parts. I left them on their white cards in their packaging because they're so much easier to see that way. The fine detail, there goes my pinky going by. Railings, guardrails, that's netting, so that soldiers don't, or seamen don't fall into the water, or Marines are transporting them. Ladders, you'll likely need a photo etch bending tool, which Model Rectifier Corporation does carry. On the other side, we have more railings. Just see how minuscule, I mean, we're talking half a millimeter photo etched metal. Not done yet. We've got more railings. We've got a crane that we looked at in the manual that you will fold. That's why you're more than likely going to need a photo etch bending tool. And Model Rectifier has those tools. Look at the railings there. Get up close so you can see them. Again, pinky for scale. So I recommend a good set of photo etch scissors and a good photo etch bending tool. It's called photo etch, as in photograph etching. You should Google this on how that's done. It is amazing. This is actually brass, is what this is. And all the teeny tiny details that will go into making what looks to be the market's finest Big Mo, the USS Missouri. This is the last set of photo etch on both sides of the card. Absolutely gorgeous. So that's it. That is our USS Missouri BB-63. I will have a slideshow of all the parts trees right coming up now. We want to thank Model Rectifier Corporation. It's in stock. I will link in the description. If you can't get it on Model Rectifier Corporation's website, they do sell to hobby shops. So just go to your hobby shop, ask for HobbyBoss Kit 86516, and they'll be able to set you up through Model Rectifier Corporation. Thanks again for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.